Lorraine Pascale, and this is all about fast, fresh and easy food.
Delicious meals don't have to take a long time to make. And for me, cooking from fresh ingredients is the way to go.
Great food can be fast and delicious with these effortless recipes and a few simple shortcuts.
Follow my tips and hopefully you'll never want to reach for a ready-made meal again.
Making quick, tasty food for everyday meals and last-minute entertaining. It can all be so easy. Cookies and cream fudge brownies. I've had a lifelong love affair with them, and I have a super speedy recipe. This is Whitney, where I grew up, and where my brownie obsession began. My obsession was so bad that when I was 8 years old, I needed more money to fund my brownie habit. So I hopped on my bike and scoured the shops for gainful employment. Finally, the ironmonger's wife took pity on me and she paid me £1 an hour to iron their smalls and sheets. So I had enough money to support my brownie habit. Needless to say, now I have a fantastic, super fast recipe for chocolate brownies. So making the brownies couldn't be easier. I've melted 165 grams of butter in the pan and then turned the heat off. I'm just finishing grating 200 grams of dark chocolate. And when you go to the cooking section where all the flour is in the supermarket, often they have baking chocolate. Avoid that because it just doesn't taste very good at all. So I don't like bain-maries and all of that for melting my chocolate. This is just a super quick way to getting your chocolate melted. I've got 3 eggs in here and 2 yolks. And my favourite thing, the vanilla pod. Just all the way down the centre of the pod. Split it open and then get the back of the knife and scrape it off. Get that whisking. We're going to make a sort of foam because there's no raising agent in this. So the only air it's going to get is from whisking. Brownie purists will shoot me down in flames, but I like to use brown sugar for my brownies. It just gives a little bit more of a caramelised flavour. 165 grams. This is now perfect. It's really important to add the sugar in 2 lots. This way you won't knock out all the air and you'll give it a chance to whisk up again in between goes. I can't tell you how much I love brownies and I love experimenting as well. I've had a few disasters, but this one really works. I'll bung the other half in and give it another whisk. So I'm not looking for this to increase like 7 times like a big meringue, but it will get a little bit more voluminous. See how that's frothed up a little bit, but it's still got some lovely bubbles in there. And my chocolate's all melted. Because we don't want to knock the bubbles out, just pour the chocolate around the edge of the bowl. Oh, look at that. I'll have that later with a teaspoon. 2 tablespoons of flour, and I really never bother sifting. And 1 of cocoa powder for extra chocolatiness. A little pinch of salt, and we're going to fold it all together. Now, folding is very different to mixing. It's a very slow and gentle process. A lot of people use metal spoons, but for me, I prefer a spatula because you can really scrape down to the bottom of the bowl like that. And it does take a little bit of time, but that's fine. Keep folding it around. So that'll do for me. There's a few lumps in there, but there's no point losing sleep over that. Next, add the chocolate and cream cookies. So just crumble them in. I've got 100 grams here. I like to put half in now, and then once I've popped the mix in the tin, I'll crumble some more in afterwards. So just a few more cookies on top, and then I'll pop it into the oven for about 25 to 30 minutes at 180 degrees. But do check after about 20 minutes, because brownies need to have a little bit of gooiness in the middle, and you don't want to overcook them, and ovens vary so much. Once they're done, leave them to cool completely in a tin, and then cut them up and sprinkle them with icing sugar. There. Dense, gooey, fudgy. You're gonna have to excuse me. I've got brownies to eat.